गुड इवनिंग मैम। गुड
इवनिंग मैम।
सो टुडे वी विल बी विजिटिंग जू, अम्यूजमेंट पार्क एंड एयरपोर्ट्स ऑफ चाइना। एंड फॉर टुडे योर पायलट इज डोनिया एंड योर को पायलट इज मनवीर एंड अदर क्रू मेंबर्स आर इंद्रानी एंड सुरभि। सो ओवर टू यू डोनिया।
Yes, thank you, Shruti, for that introduction. Could you please enable me to share my screen?
Just.
Yeah, got it. Thank you. Okay, so hi guests. So today we will be visiting China and the zoos, amusement parks, and airports in China. I will just share a small presentation so that we can make it a little more easier. I hope my screen is visible.
Ma'am, it is visible.
All right.
Ma'am, it is visible.
Thank you. Okay.
Ma'am, now, visible.
Yes, I understood. Yeah, thank you so much. Now, moving on. So China is, as most of you might be knowing, it is an East Asian country and it is a huge country with the largest population in the world. And its capital city is called Beijing and the largest city is called Shanghai. And the official language that they speak is Chinese. Now, let's just start exploring the different zoos in China. So the first zoo that we'll talk about is the Shimlong Safari Park. So this park is actually located in a place that is near Guangzhou. It is also known as the Xiangjiang Safari Park. So here it has a lot of beautiful and exotic animals, and it is home for world's largest number of white tigers. And white tigers is an exotic animal because it is very rare. It's almost an extinct species of tigers. Then it also has a giant panda center. Then for the people who come to visit the park, it has a safari on wheels where you will be taken through the park. And this will be in a vehicle with a guide who will talk about the different animals that you can find as well. Then there is, as a attraction part, there are rhinos, hippos, koala bears, kangaroos and all, which are not native to China. These are all from different parts of the world. They have brought them here and you can see those animals as well. And the highlights are you can feed giraffe as well as ride elephants in this park.
This is a safari of China we are doing today.
We are going through China, all these zoos in China. Okay. So now, can you tell me what is this animal?
A panda.
Ma'am, panda.
That's right. It's a panda. Then what about
white
this?
Tiger.
White tiger.
Correct. And
ma'am,
this
white
one?
Tiger.
Koala.
Ma'am, koala. Ma'am, koala bear.
Correct. Koala bear. And what about this?
Rhinoceros.
Ma'am, rhinoceros.
That's right. It is a rhinoceros. And what about this?
Flamingo.
Correct. So this is a flamingo. Now all these animals you can find in the safari park that we just discussed. Okay. Now coming to the next, which is the Yunnan Wildlife Park. So this is like the name suggests, it is located in Yunnan and it has a wide variety of animals and birds. That is over 200 animals and birds in this wildlife park. And it also has an animal kindergarten and animal nursery area. So animal nursery area is where the newborn animals are taken care of and given proper care as well. And then there is also a rare animal area and many other attractions. And some of the, so rare animal areas there, right? So there will be some rare animals that you can find, that you cannot find everywhere. So those would include the orangutan. Then there is a red panda. The orangutan looks like this. Then there is the red panda. Then there is a black panther. And it also has black swan, flamingo, and golden eagle as well. So all of these are the rare animals in this wildlife park. Okay. Now coming to the next, it is called the Shimlong Ocean Kingdom. So the previous two parks that we discussed, both of them had land animals. Now this is a little bit of, it's a little bit different because this is all about aquatic life. That is animals and fishes and all that you can find in the polar regions and in the ocean. So this is situated in a place called Hengwin Zhuhai. It has an aquarium. It has rides like Polar Explorer and Penguin Coaster, which will take you throughout the kingdom and help you explore the zoo. Then one of the main attraction is the dolphin show and the sea lion show, as you would have seen in a lot of videos where you can see these dolphins being trained and sea lions as well. Then musical fountain is also there. And one important thing about this is that it is the world's biggest aquarium, and they have a whale shark tank, and whale sharks are very huge. So this tank is also very huge because it should resemble their natural habitat. So this is a sea lion, and this is a beluga dolphin, and this is a walrus. Okay.
Ma'am, it's not called beluga dolphin. It's called beluga whale.
Okay, sorry, beluga whale then. Okay, so we'll just see a small video. So that was the video.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, go ahead.
Ma'am, we have class on 5:30, so we can leave.
And then the dolphin show. The sea lion show, and also we saw the shark whale tank. Okay. Now there is another
question.
Yes, please ask.
That I saw a fish that had parts like it was flapping it like birds.
I know what that is.
Yes, please tell me, Kabir.
It's called manta ray.
Okay. Okay, so moving on, we look into Dalian Forest Zoo. So this is a zoo that is located in the Bayon area, which is a mountain area, and it has more than 200 plus species of animals and birds. And it also has a rare animal section in the reptile pavilion. And this is one of the main attractions of the zoo. So here, there is also a performance in Happy Theater, and it also has an elephant behavior pavilion. These are also the main attractions of the zoo. So if you can see, this is the this is how big the zoo is. It has a lot of area and a lot of different animals and centers that has been labeled here. Then now moving on, we will look into the airports of China. Now the most important one is the Beijing Capital International Airport. This is one of the two main international airports in Beijing. And it is also China's largest airport. So Beijing is the capital city of China. So this is one of the major airports in China. And it is also one of the world's busiest airports, both in terms of passenger as well as the cargo traffic. And it has three terminals. So this is the photo of the airport. Then another one is the Shanghai Pudong International Airport. This is a major aviation hub for East Asia. So when you say an aviation hub, it means that a lot of flights from different locations will come to this point. And then from here, they will travel to different other locations. So there will be a lot of passengers coming in through this airport. And it is located in Pudong, Shanghai. Shanghai is the biggest, is the largest city in China, as we discussed in the first slide. It also has 3 terminals, 2 runways, and this is the 3rd busiest airport in China. So this is the photo of the airport. As you can see, it is also very architecturally beautiful. Then comes the Beijing Daxing International Airport. So this is the second largest international airport in Beijing. Like how we said, Beijing capital was there, one among the two. This is the second one. And it is nicknamed as the starfish, because if you can see, its shape looks like that of a star, but it just has an extra leg. So, and it was also awarded the best airport by Hygiene Measures in Asia Pacific, and that is in 2020. So that is very recently. Now another small video on airports. And as it was, yes. So as mentioned in the video itself, they are talking about how they decided on building a new airport in Beijing and the reason for that, and how they came to be, and the budget, and all the main points in their infrastructure, and so on. Okay. So. Now coming to the next airport, which is the Shenzhen Bu'an Airport. This is located in the east bank of Pearl River in Bu'an district. So this picture that you see is the airport. And this airport is known for its beauty in China. So if you can see this terminal, this picture itself, it looks very unique. The ceiling and the lights, everything has a different feel to it. So that is why this airport is known for its beauty in China. And also a new terminal was built with the architect Massimiliano Fucas of Rome. Now moving on, we will look into the amusement parks. So the first one is the Happy Valley Beijing. So this is located in the Xiaoyang district of Beijing, and there are more than 40 rides, and among that 10 are extreme rides. So here, as additional to the amusement rides that they have, there is a IMAX theater with 7 screens and shopping malls, and as well. So this is kind of like a total package where you can go and go for a normal shopping experience or a movie, and along with that, you can go for an amusement park experience as well. So here, along with their roller coasters and other rides, they have also many art shows that are there. So here they have the acrobatics, and kung fu, which are the main attractions. So this is the picture of the a few pictures of the amusement park. As you can see, it is a very huge huge area, and it has a lot of rides as well as the theaters and all are there. So another one is the Xinjiang Action Park. This is located in Shanghai. Can you please mute yourself, whoever is talking? So this is located in Shanghai, and it is known for its Ferris wheel. So if you have gone to an amusement park, most of the amusement parks have this huge wheel on which you will sit and it will rotate. And on the edges there will be different seats, so that is called a Ferris wheel, and it has a huge wheel which actually if you start from one point to come back to that point, it takes about 20 to 25 minutes. Apart from these rides, they also have other attractions like malls, cafes, restaurants, etc. So this is a small picture to like
ma'am?
To understand.
Ma'am.
Yes.
The third one, it is the Ferris wheel.
Correct. It's a Ferris wheel, right? So this is that Ferris wheel, which is a major attraction over here. And as I mentioned before, from one point to reach to that point again, it will take about 20 minutes. And then, as you can see, it has a roller coaster, which is also another attraction, and then pirate ship and all is other attractions that it has. Now coming to Shanghai Disneyland. So if you're a person who likes Disney movies and Disney characters, and you've grown watching its cartoons, this is something you will find.
It also has.
Yes. Disneyland is there in a variety of places. Paris has it and many other areas have it. Shanghai also has a Disneyland. Sorry?
Even in India, there's Disneyland.
Okay. So this, as you might already be figuring it out, it is a Disney-based, or it's a Disney-based theme park, and this is located in Pudong, Shanghai. So this park is operated by Walt Disney Group, as well as by Shanghai Shendi Group. And it has about 7 theme parks like Fantasyland, Toy Story Land, Mickey Avenue, and so on. So as you would expect, it would have a lot of cartoon characters from Disney movies like the Mickey Mouse, the Donald Duck, and they will be roaming around. You can take pics with them and so on. It also has boat rides, themed restaurants, Disney princesses, castle stages, and it also has a treasure cove with Captain Jack Sparrow in it. So these are all the major attractions in this place. We'll just see a small video on the Disney, on the Disneyland as well. Because all of us would have watched Disney movies, and when you see that, you'll feel like going there, right?
Ma'am, I know the movie Zootopia.
Correct. Yeah, it was a very good movie. Anyone has been to Disneyland? Any Disneyland?
Ma'am, I've not gone to Disneyland, but I know Disneyland.
Oh, that's ma'am. Great. Who was the person who's gone to Disneyland?
Me.
Yeah, Chakha. Which Disneyland did you go to?
American.
Okay, how was it? Can you share your experience with others?
Yeah, there were various parades. There were various different rides, virtual reality rides, various roller coasters.
Yeah.
So that time Disney was different. It didn't own these various companies like Marvel at that time. So it was quite different.
Okay. So did you enjoy it?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks for sharing. Yeah. So the next one that we'll look into is the Shimlong Paradise. This is the largest amusement park in China, and it has 6 attractions and boasts of 10 inversion roller coasters. Now, this group also includes the resort, Safari Park, Ocean Kingdom, and also an international circus. And we already discussed the Shimlong Ocean Kingdom and the Shimlong Safari Park, if you remember, in the beginning of the presentation. Now, it also has themed areas like Kids Land, Rainbow Bay with Dive Coaster, Waterland, Phantom Zone with Rainforest, and many more like that. So these are a few pictures of the Shimlong Paradise, and we'll just have a small video of that, and that would be the end. So, give me 1 second, I'll share this. With respect to China. So that is it with
it
respect to China.
It was scary.
Yeah, it was. But it was also fun. That's it from my end. Shruti, do you want to take over?
Yes. So I hope everyone enjoyed your tour.
Yes, ma'am. We enjoyed it.
Bambi.
Yes. Was the most fun.
Great.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That's nice. You all enjoyed. So let's meet tomorrow. Okay. So let's meet tomorrow. Tomorrow we will visit Egypt. The zoo and amusement park of Egypt. Okay,
ma'am. Which country will we visit tomorrow?
Egypt.
What about Egypt. The airports?
Yes, airports, amusement parks, and zoos of Egypt. Okay,
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Okay, so yes.
Nile River also has a stop at Egypt.
Yes, it has. Okay, so thank you everyone. Thank you for joining us today. See you all tomorrow.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Have a good day, ma'am.